Johnson says the president is in good health for his age, but says he has high cholesterol and should try to exercise some more. They also say he scored perfect on a cognitive assessment, showing no signs of mental decline. Democrats and Republicans are at odds right now over what to do about the Dreamers. Those are young people who were brought into this country illegally as children. Meanwhile, the government, well, it's facing a shutdown. Chief political correspondent Scott Thuman has developments in Washington.
Hoping voices will carry their concerns, but also deliver votes. Dreamers like Carolina Ramirez filled this Senate building and swarmed offices.
You can imagine what it can feel like to be someone who loves your home, and then all of a sudden for people to say, no, you just cannot live here.
The 28-year-old from Houston fears possible deportation to Mexico if a deal isn't struck and fast.
Congress needs to get it together because these are human lives we're talking about.
You think that's realistic?
I think it's yes.
President Trump Tuesday exuding an open arms approach to immigrants.
I want them to come in from everywhere, everywhere.
Critics, though, don't buy it and are threatening to withhold support for a spending bill due Friday to avoid a government shutdown.
Let's stop postponing this a week or two at a time, for goodness sakes. And it's an embarrassment to Congress that we can't reach an agreement.
The last time we saw tensions like this, there was a government shutdown, 2013 under President Obama, and it was over another passionate debate, health care.
So will Democrats back down and keep the lights on, but go without a deal keeping Dreamers in the country? Or do Republicans grant Dreamers' wishes in order to keep the government running? Possible additional casualties of an impasse, government workers, a thriving stock market that just broke 26,000, and even the military, which defense officials claim is suffering, perhaps even losing its readiness due to a constant unpredictability each time government funding comes into question. In Washington, I'm Scott Thuman.
Now, the calendar has turned to 2018, and millions of Americans are wondering what's in store for their country in the new year. We're hosting a roundtable discussion on the state of America. It's on Thursday. It's at 5 o'clock in the afternoon, and you can watch it streaming on our website, IdahoNews.com.